How many years have passed? Time for us has resumed its march. Sigwaridus.
Yes, what is it?
You may begin. I trust you have worked out each detail?
Oh, I can assure you, every word.
Then away with you.
We have a prophecy to fulfill.
Yes, let us usher in a new age of history.
I always like Final Fantasy villains. They're always really cool. Okay, combined abilities. Layered abilities. Stacking mirages with abilities of like elements causes those abilities to layer into a more powerful form. For example, stacking three mirages with fire and Fyra results in a stack that can wield Faraga. Tama's Foxfire is a fire attack too, so it can be used as a substitute. Oh, okay. Combo abilities. If you stack mirages that use physical weapons like swords and fangs, the stack will be able to wield combo abilities like Cross Slash. Of course, that's not the only example, so tinker around with it and see what you can come up with. Super abilities. Some L-sized characters have super abilities. For example, Giant Rain can wield one called Channel Element. Tama's always wanted her own super ability, but she's just not big enough. Okay, save your progress. Absolutely. Oh, is that the goddess girl? Could have been, but I don't think so. But yeah, that did look like Bahamut.
Now would be a good time to stock up on items.
Good call. We've racked up a ton of gil now that you mention it.
You have to wonder why a bunch of mirages are carrying so much cash.
Let's just say that in a crow...
Never mind, I figured...
Whoops. Hello. Guess we're not done. And they're catchable now. Yes. Okay, so... They might all be catchable. This might be a bit of a pain. Let's try going for him first. Never mind. Well, that didn't work. Go with the Red Guard Captain first. Damn it. Alright. Guess we're just gonna take down all but one, just so we're not getting pummeled here. Okay, this guy's gonna hurt a bit. But I can unstack. Let's see, probably shouldn't have unstacked like this. But that's okay. Actually, this could be a serious problem. Okay, so we want to do abilities. Who's this? Libra, yes. Okay, so we have Red Cap. Deal a lot of damage at once to create a prism tunity. Requires a Red Cap prism. We probably already have that. Alright, it's Ifrit. Okay. Chocochick, Cure, Lan. Let's see. Okay. He's probably hurting pretty hard. Let's stack back up. Let's imprism. Got him. Alright. I'm not sure if I actually want one, but I'll catch it anyway. And we're injured. But that's okay. And we got a red cap. You can't accuse these little scamps of hitting below the belt, because they go for your eyes instead. Untrue fact, they turn their helmets red by sheer willpower. So it looks like they can be... Oh, they can equally switch between, let's get rid of the floating eye for the time being. I don't really care about the floating eye. I mostly just want to switch them around so we actually have both entries.
Never mind, I figured it was her.
Okay, so we want to do stack setup. No. We want to do mirage boards. Red cap. So the red cap can easily switch between red captain. Or, no, we just know the Red Captain. Okay. I'm confused by this. Well, we'll catch them all. Probably. Okay. Yeah, I don't really care for the Red Cap, honestly. But I'll catch him because I'm compulsive and have no reason why not to. They built this place in a hurry. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything else around here. Ah, but there is a save point, so we can go back and heal. Yes! Alright, so what are we up against? Okay, so we want to do... Let's see. Topple strength. Low. Medium. Let's try throw stone at a... Oh, that's just a goblin stack. Well, let's kill the Red Cap. Okay, I don't think we're going to be able to take the regular goblin, but that's okay. I don't really care that much. Abilities, let's just do cure, because she's going to die otherwise. Okay, there goes the Red Cap. Okay, now let's see if I can unstack them. We could do double strength, but I think throw stone does less damage. Alternatively, I could just kill them and go for the non-stacked variants, because that's going to be more of a pain in the butt. Let's see. Have I ever had anybody walk into my room and wonder who I'm talking to? Nope. I've been a professional Let's Player as long as anybody's known it. I guess the only time that it was weird was when my brother had friends over once. That does not happen often. Okay, so we got this taken care of. Now let's just zoom around. Yeah, I also live alone, save for with my fiance, so it's not like there's a whole lot of random people to walk in. I guess I did have one point. Come on. Enough with this stack nonsense. I actually had one point a couple years ago where my brother, one of my brother's friends, who was kind of a dick to me in high school, had actually, like, come into my room while I was working on videos or something to actually apologize for being a dick. For years, which surprised me because I'm not used to that sort of thing. But that was about it. Okay.
Yeah,
we're still waiting for a regular goblin to show his face, or a goblin captain or whatever. I mean, it really doesn't matter that much. But yeah, I'm just gonna stick my face in that occasionally. Part of it is, also want to get Chocochick up to a chocobo, because chocobos are adorable. Though, I'm not entirely sure if I'm going to want to use them. Okay. Oh! Unlike in Pokemon, your chances to catch a Mirage does not increase based on their HP. Alright, we might actually want to go back to the beginning of this area. Because there's too many goblin stacks, and this is a pain in the butt. I guess we could just walk out the regular way. Yeah, let's do that. Technically, I did this off-camera last time, but
no trouble at all.
Victory!
It's better than, like, just milling about in a circle in this endgame zone, which seems to have nothing but goblin stacks to confuse and annoy me. That'd be not a bad idea. Okay. Let's go back. Couldn't be a YouTuber where you live. The building manager would yell at you. Yeah, I picked this apartment very specifically because it was reputed to have, Jesus. It's the same thing. This building was reputed, or this apartment complex was reputed to have, like, really, really dense floors and walls and stuff, so I was just like, yes. I've heard my neighbors, like, a couple of times, but only when they're actually, like, arguing loudly and stuff. So it's like, okay, don't have to worry about it.
That was a good fight.
All right!
Okay. Taken a while. Yeah, I'm actually really curious, what am I thinking? I'm really curious what the, the balances. Like, what, for example, would a fully grown chocobo that's like mirage boarded out be just as good as any other mirages that you find along the way in this game? Can you just, like, give me an opportunity to catch one of you guys? Because, like, you're just stacking Mandragoras just to make yourself inconvenient here. And I hate it. I'm not even going to stoop to your level. I wonder if it's because we're done with the area. Okay, Chocochick's level 8. Eh, we're getting there. Yeah, if we're done with the area, we're running into different enemy groups as an result. Not entirely sure. Enter is required again. The lights change. I assume that means you have a better chance. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I figured it's not based on low health. Oh, hey. Spare treasure chest I wouldn't have gotten otherwise. I never got blinded, by the way. I don't know what they were talking about. But, I assume there are a lot of ways that you can improve your chances. It's just a bit arbitrary on what. What the? Oh, I'm ambushed. Okay, right. We probably want to pick a person with subdue. The sylph might actually have subdue, come to think of it. I might actually toss that on instead of freak for the time being.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you have to try it. Keep a mirage with you the entire game. I'm probably gonna do that, actually. What I'm probably gonna do is just keep Chocochick with me. Freaking love Chocobos. Okay, so what we wanna do is stack setup. Let's switch Freet with, I wanna say it was Sylph. Probably should have checked that before I did the stack setup. Yep, there it is. Okay, so we do have a subdue if we need it. And this way they both have healing. And everybody else just being in our party will always get us some experience. So even if we don't have Freet with us necessarily, we still have Freet with us enough. Okay. Oh, here we go. We got some options. All right. So we want to kill you. Well, I'd like to. Okay. So, what we want to do is abilities. Let's just do subdue on the Red Captain. Actually, you know what? He's got enough. Let's just do Cure. I'll put him on healing duty while we catch the Red Captain. Abilities. Subdue Red Captain. Oh, we're not going to be catching that Red Captain today. Alright, screw it. Beat him up. I guess we'll just go with healing. Heal him up. And then she can just do abilities. Whisper Wind. Whisper Wind is such a ridiculously strong move. Holy crap, that does even more damage now. Okay. Well, I guess I'll just, I mean, part of it is I'm kind of halfway tempted to just leave. I guess let's catch a regular goblin. Yeah, the problem is if I don't catch it now, we're gonna, if we don't catch a regular goblin now, It's pretty much going to be impossible to get one later. Just because it's going to be really hard to catch them. I wonder if Subdue doesn't necessarily trigger. I'll have to think about it. I mean, at this point, we're also... let's see. I wonder... I think I can actually heal enemies, too. Yeah, I can. Okay, well... Nothing but... these guys. Actually, in retrospect, isn't there, like, one more area before this? I think there is, so we might actually want to keep going, because... we're getting wobbly! But it's okay. Wobbly is hilarious. Okay, Chocochick's level 9. Yeah, the other thing is, like, the other thing is I can just... Not? I don't know. Yeah, but if we catch just the regular goblin type, I can always convert it up. Which is, I guess, kind of part of the benefit. Okay, let's see. Do the goblins with different colors hat have different abilities? They're different monsters. Like, they're different classifications. The ones with the shields are the same, just like an alternate version. So a red hat with a shield is the same as a not red hat. You just have to switch them around. Whereas the regular goblins are kind of a different beast. Okay, here we go. Okay. Kill him. Okay. Next up, we want to do Libra on one of these guys. So what's it? Yep. Once per battle, reduce the Mirage's HP, Prism Tunity. Okay. Let's unstack. Unstack. Okay. Okay. Okay, there we go. We want to imprison. Got him! Alright. And then everybody just beats the crap out of him.
That
perfect!
Wasn't so bad.
Alright, so now we got ourselves a goblin. I'll probably switch out another one of the non-useful ones just so I can take a look at it. Yeah, so if you... Oh, interesting. So, instead of being interchangeable, this guy actually has a third level, which might be the really tall one. I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, goblin. A mirage that travels in numbers, has a nasty set of gnashers, but rarely attacks by biting. After all, goblin punching is way, way more satisfying. Okay, so now we can switch them around, and now we can leave. Let's see, who can I switch them out for? I'll switch him out for the red cap. I'd rather have a goblin than a red cap, considering he's got a third level. Even though, honestly, I'm not a big fan of them. They're cute, but I'm not a big fan of humanoid monsters-ish. I'd rather have the really interesting looking ones. And right, we're going out this way. Yeah, technically I could have taken the escape gate, not done any of this, but I don't know, I'm a completionist when it comes to Pokemon-ish games. It's fun. Actually, I should probably turn off auto here. Oh yeah, they do have flash. They just keep missing. That's okay, this is why we have Whisper Wind. God, Whisper Wind is ridiculous. Like, it makes Cure look like just a sad, sad, useless move. And it's probably gonna be really good for the entirety of the game. That's the most ridiculous part about it. Like, I should be able to actually just use it forever.
That was a good
victory.
Don't want that black Chocochick? There's not a black Chocochick in this area. There's one in the area beyond the shortcut. Motherfucker. Alright. Well, there's an exit gate out there, but... area beyond the shortcut? Alright, I'm gonna Google this.
Yeah, we got this.
I guess we're doing...
Oh. It might be one of those special ones. Okay, here we go.
No trouble at all.
Predictable.
Oh, I don't want to look at the YouTube video. I don't like watching other people's YouTube videos, even if they're helpful. Okay. These are not actually useful informations. Okay, here we go. Yeah, so, oh, hey, there's actually a list. So... apparently there's a boss reward or secret area in the Nether Nebula where you get the remaining ones that you didn't get. In the Watch Blade Plains, there's a black Chocochick in a special area at the end of the game. Okay, so we finally have our list of things to catch and where to catch them. Perfect. Thank you for cluing me in on that one. I would not have found it otherwise. Okay, and... I really want my Chocobo to get up to 10. Because once I get the Chocobo, we get up there. Okay. If I see the opportunity to catch one of the goblins with the shields, I will. But...
Good job.
I don't know. If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen, and I'm not going to feel heartbroken about it. It's going to take a while before Chocochick gets up there, though. And we're going to be next to the, shortcut. The only problem is wasted time, but honestly, I don't really see it as wasted time. I just see it as fun, because I actually really like this game. And I really like the monster leveling game. Seems like a lot of the reviews for this game are kind of, like, grumbly about it gets boring after a while, and you know what? I could totally see that happening. But for now, I'm gonna have a good time. And honestly, I got through Digimon, and this is already by far a better game than Digimon ever was, so it's just like, eh, my standards are incredibly low. Oh, hi. Okay. Let's see. Can't block me if I'm doing this. Okay. Hold on. We might want to rethink our plan here. Let's see if I can catch the red captain. So I don't even have to think about it anymore. Yep. Inflict confusion. Well, never mind. I don't think I'm doing inflict confusion ever. Oh, they even have a cure spell. Oh, whoops. God damn it. Well, never mind.
No,
we win anyway.
So
yes. Okay. That's good experience for everybody. Yeah, so I guess I'm not getting a red captain, but that's fine. I don't need one anyway. I've already got one. Just eventually, if I ever care. I mean, what we're probably going to do is get to the very end of the game and be like, or, you know, a much higher level area, and I'm just going to be like, I'm going to drag along some, like, kind of useless monsters that I don't care about. And get them up at least to complete my log, so I can see everything. Let's see. Ah. Sleepy. There need to be more monster collection games, just in general. I'm thinking about it now, and I'm like, this is kind of... monster collection games are generally one of the more, compelling, like, RPGs ever. Or at least RPGs I'm really interested in. Like, I'm trying to think of RPGs that have drawn me in as much as games where you can collect little pet monsters to fight for you instead. I'm gonna be honest, Pokemon's lost me just because they haven't changed their formula ever. And that's why I always like picking up other games that have more interesting ones instead. So for example, you know, I mean, this game, really, really nice, like the Mirage Board. I really, really like the Mirage Board. And there's like a new Digimon game coming out soon that I think is going to be closer to like Digimon World 1. Which I'm kind of excited for. But that'll be out next year. I'm trying to think if there are any other like particularly great. Monster Collection games lately. I mean, I like the fan mods for... I like the fan... like the fan games for Pokemon. Those are always kind of interesting. Oops. Should probably turn off auto mode for a second. We have some moves that are... that generally make this a bit faster. Even if... I don't know. Maybe going through my inventory... is a bit less... Mainly, I just want to use Whisper Wind so I get back up to full health. There we go. We should probably heal up Lon at some point. Eh, don't care. Oh, right. We've got a Healy area next. Okay, here we go. Well, I guess we'll save, seeing as I've done, like, a stupid amount of... kind of nothing. Kind of grinding. Bit of both, really. Okay. So, oh yeah, it does look like there's an area on the opposite side. I should probably also take a look at the original cave, because apparently you can get Babliz and Zapped from the... You can get Babliz and Zapped from a secret area, or a special area, somewhere in the Nether Nebula. So if I can actually get my hands on, if I can actually get my hands on that, that'd be cool. It'd be fun to get all of the. I was about to call them starters, but that's absolutely not what they are. But that's okay. All right. Let's see. So it's probably over here on the opposite side, on the very, very far end. Yeah. There it is. You know, I saw this, but I actually thought it was something else. But here we are. I've saved recently, so we should be able to just fight it. Now, is it something special? Oh. All right. This sucker might hurt. Alright, so this is... her group. Let's split. They're pretty full HP. Okay. Let's Libra him. How much HP do you have? 327. Okay, restore the Mirage's HP to create Prism Tunity. Interesting. Well, in that case, we want to stack back up. I want to try something. Abilities. Okay. Can't do too much. What we can do is subdue him. And we can do cure. Chocochick. Okay. So what we want to do, abilities, subdue. If we're lucky, we can stack this multiple times, make it easier. Think it might have gotten easier, I'm not entirely sure. Either way, I'm gonna have to start healing Lon anyway. Got it! Alright, so we got a black Chocochick now.
Good job.
And it was worth a lot of EXP, so we actually get our Chocochick up to 10. Ryan and Lan up to Rain and land up to 10? I don't know. I'm excited. Alright. Chocochick. Aw. It only goes... it only has two forms. Anyway, a Chocochick born with black feathers. Even their bones are black, just like a certain rare breed of chicken. For whatever reason, just their eyes are red. Allergies, perhaps? Alright, view abilities. Alright, so we've got haste, ram, subdue, stroll. Ooh. Looks pretty decent. Keeping him around. Let's take it with us. Goodbye, goblin. Actually, no. We'll get rid of the black knack. I'm gonna have both Chocochicks. But yes, it is adorable. And we might be able to get a better healing move from this, too. And we got a black Chocochick memento. And 10 ethers. Wow. Wow. Okay, that was awesome. They're adorable. I really like the design work they put into this game. They did a wonderful job with that. Oh, right. Time to actually get some of our payoff. So, we've got a lot of SP on a lot of our dudes. Time to start milking that. Okay, so we could get a baby with prison, but I really don't care. So let's get counter. And that. Yeah, because it's going to take forever before we get either of these. Okay, 23 might not be so bad. I'm actually going to be able to have a behemoth before I can go catch the previous behemoth, probably. Okay, copper gnome. He can at the very least get a stat up. Okay. Oh. He might actually be able to get the next one up. Let's see, that only costs one, so we might as well get... We might as well get defense. The more that we stack, the better. Chocochick! Alright. Alright, so we can now transfig into a chocobo. Now, admittedly, we still want to go back and get all of these at some point. Ah! Unlock a Mirage board. I actually have no idea how we use it, necessarily. Well, that's okay. We'll figure it out very shortly. How's Tama doing? I haven't really messed with her too much. So yeah, she's not going to be able to do much. There's Stroll, but I don't care. Yeah, part of the reason why I haven't been using Tama is she doesn't actually have a whole lot of useful moves. Just stats. The stats are nice, though. I guess I'll just get accuracy. We'll just start clearing this thing out. Yeah, because we're not going to be able to do much with Tama. That's why I haven't used her. Because I'd rather work on the mirages that we actually have, like, benefits for. I mean, look at Freed. He's got four forms total. That's awesome. This level 15. Obtain a thing. Oh. Can't get enhanced fire. Guess we'll wait on that one. Oh, you can only transfigure in the Mirage case. You're right. I was kind of hoping I'd be able to switch it around freely. Oh, right. We should probably actually get rid of this mini golem. Probably? The main problem with the mini golem is there's just not a whole lot of, like, upper limits for him. Like, all of his upper limits are, like, 35 or some random thing that we don't know about. Okay, what else is there? This interface is really slow to chug through. Let's take a look at Moo. Admittedly, I don't really have a whole lot of use for Moo anymore either. Ah, but he is about to hit level... Once he hits level 10, I guess we'll keep him around for a little while. Plus, he's got regen, which is pretty boss. Okay, last one is just the goblin. Yeah, I wish the interface navigated a little bit faster. Let's see. So what's this? Blank space, shell. I'm probably just gonna push him forward this way. Because we've got... Ooh, auto potion. Interesting. Because... Oh! Mirage board for the red cap. I still don't understand how the unlocked mirage boards even work. That's an interesting thing for me. Because we also have the Sylph, who I am using, despite the fact that her upper limit is a mystery, her actual effects are pretty damn good. Enhanced cure. Oh, neat. Though she doesn't have cure herself, does she? No. Weird. She does have an empty spot, but not so much so. Okay. Oh, let's get out of here. Finally. Took forever. Actually, yep. Yeah, return to Ninewood Hills. Let's see.
So, why don't we go back to Cornelia and see Princess Sarah?
For starters, access Prism Case. Chocobo. Wait, no, that's not what I want to do. Ah, transfigs. Oh, whoa. Also, apparently chocobos are medium-sized. I was expecting chocobos to be not medium-sized. Ha, well, that's interesting. Okay. Alright, so I'm probably not going to switch out my party for the time being. This does mean I'll be swapping the copper gnome out. Hey, we're going to have a chocobo stack. That's going to be adorable. Alright, let's figure this out for a second. Stacks it up. See, I was expecting the chocobo to be... I was expecting the chocobo to be, like, straight up to large. But that's okay. So, interesting point... You can actually have chocobos. Okay, I wanna check this again. Axis Prism Case. This might actually be way more flippy doodle than I thought it was going to be. Transfiguration. So I can't do anything with the mini golem. The goblin, on the other hand, can transfig into a red cap if I want to. The reason why that's actually really cool is it means technically, if I want to, I can actually potentially use every Mirage board, maybe. Which could be really good. I'm really curious about these things. Like, this might actually have, like, really interesting, useful things. Because, yeah, I can totally turn this Chocobo into a Black Chocochick if I really wanted to. And vice versa. I'm excited to try these things out, which does mean stuff like the Sylph, maybe not as good, but still, it's fun. And we got a whole Chocobo stack to work with. Oh yeah, let's save, just because I've been doing a lot of things here. Okay. I've completed a grand total of one chapter today in like 2 hours. I did spend a ton of time running around like a dingus.
Chapter 5. The Champion Who Saved Grimoire.
From the looks of it, the Bahamutian encampment is going to stay a goblin the hangout for good.
At least they'll leave Cornelia alone for a while, now that we've gotten rid of the soldier controlling them.
Once mirages are scattered and separated from their keeper, they revert to their wild state.
And wild mirages are something you just learn to get used to in Grimoire.
That's why you've got Mr. Warrior here.
Yes, indeed. However, we cannot rule out the possibility of another Bahamut attack. What we need is an alliance with another country. Some sort of mutual agreement to come to each other's defense.
Actually, word has been spreading of such an organization. An anti-federation group as large as a nation. Perhaps the time has come to formally introduce ourselves. They call themselves the League of S.
League of S. Do you know of any way to reach them?
The Thane of Saronia to the north has been in contact with them. I believe one of the merchants mentioned it.
Saronia, yes. They have been resisting Federation annexation.
Yes. Highness, allow me to journey there and learn what I can about the League of S.
Alone? To get to Saronia, you must pass through all manner of places teeming with dangerous mirages. And I...
Hey, maybe we could go instead.
Yeah. Mr. Warrior here, he and the brigade should stick around and keep the goblins in line.
That's right.
Cornelia's legendary champion belongs right here in Cornelia. We're the best fit for this. We've got tons of mirages to collect, and could start just about anywhere. So, you know, it wouldn't be any trouble.
What a kind offer. You would really do that?
Sure. You're doing us a favor by pointing me and Lon in a new direction. We're glad to help.
I thank you. We are in your debt. Here, all Cornelian emissaries are given these letters as proof of their authority. It should help you on your way.
Thanks.
Well, there's no sense in hanging around. So long. Take care.
Bye-bye-bye-bye!
Your Highness,